This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Watching news tonight with me, Ashmit Kumar, and a lot is making news tonight. Now, even as Dayanidhi Maran finds himself in the eye of a storm, the Chief Minister Amma, left parties and the BJP are crying foul over alleged 2G links and are demanding the Union Minister's resignations. Also, a WHO story points at how that little mobile phone device could cause cancer amongst the users. Now, radiation fears are looming large at this point for the users, but are these fears warranted or is this only a knee-jerk reaction? And finally, it started as the battle between FedEx and the Joker. Natasha will bring us latest from the world of sports.
Yes, Ashmit, you're exactly right. Well, it's a good roundup of sports that we'll be bringing you today, whether it's FedEx or all the French Open roundup, of course, and also from, of course, the FIFA corruption scandals that have been highlighted recently and Sepp Blatter's big reaction to that. All that and more coming right up.
Natasha, we'll come back to you for more sports updates in just a bit, but first, a look at the top stories. Jayalalitha demands a pink slip for Dayanidhi Maran. Chief Minister alleges links with the 2G saga, but the Union Minister and Maxis deny charges.
So, Mr. Dayanidhi Maran should resign from the cabinet and face legal proceedings.
I think it requires a serious investigation.
BDS system is under stress, claims Amma. Writes to the Prime Minister demanding a nearly 50% hike in kerosene supply. Amma begins to deliver on election promises, free access to 20 kgs of rice for 2 crore people across the state. In the struggle for smooth power supply in the state, the Chief Minister promises to weed out corruption within the TNEB.
We were supplying quality power, uninterrupted power, round the clock to all consumers.
Milad Natraj donned the police uniform again. 2 months after his retirement, the tribunal's order to consider him for the DGP's post will be studied. This shocking World Health Organization study will make you keep away from your phone to keep the doctor away. For 14 long years, she refused to wear them, but after pleas from the party cadres, the bling is back. Well, let's also take a look at stories coming in from across the nation and the world. Top ministers meet Baba Ramdev at Delhi airport, say they will continue dialogue, but the yoga guru has not called off the fast. CBI sources say that Dayanidhi Maran could be questioned in the 2G scam. The BJP says the Prime Minister should sack Maran. Concern after Fukushima, the Prime Minister asks for the world's best nuclear safety precautions at India's plants. David Headley planned to make money from a film and a book after 2611. This testimony ends in a Chicago court. And it's Federer versus Djokovic in the French Open semi-finals. Federer is the last man to have beaten Djokovic. Well, first up this hour, a cover story in a news magazine has got the grandnephew of M. Karunanidhi, Dayanidhi Maran, embroiled over a fresh 2G controversy. Now, following speculations over the circumstances in which Maran granted a license to SL in 2007, the Chief Minister of the state, Ms. Jay Jayalalitha, today demanded the resignation of the former telecom minister from the cabinet for his alleged role in the allocation of 2G spectrum. Now, the allegation against Dayanidhi Maran is that SL, previously denied a telecom license for over 2 years, was finally given one only when its owners changed hands to Malaysia-based telecom major Maxis. Now, the charge is that Maran cleared the decks only after a sister company of Maxis invested 675 crores in Maran-owned Sun TV, which the BJP calls a conflict of interest. Now, the DMK leader has rubbished these charges.
With regard to the case of Dayanidhi Maran, I am quite sure the Prime Minister knows what should be done, and I am sure that he will do it. The Prime Minister should ask for Mr. Dayanidhi Maran's resignation from the cabinet. I am sure the Prime Minister will do it if he has not already done it. So Mr. Dayanidhi Maran should resign from the cabinet and face legal proceedings.
Well, the union minister, in fact, now has reacted to fresh spectrum charges against him. He has said that the news reports are far from the truth and malicious. He had never favoured any company over others and that there was no loss to the exchequer during his tenure. And he lastly also adds that no telecompany invested in his brother's company when he was the minister. Well, meanwhile, the Malaysian telecom major Maxis has come out with a statement attempting to steer clear of these developments. Now, they came recorded to declare, and I quote, "There was, in Maxis's knowledge, no pressure exerted on SVL to sell its stake in SL, and there is no linkage between Maxis's investment in SL and that of Astro's investment in Sun Direct TV." Well, meanwhile, the CPIM leadership also turned up the ante, mounting more pressure on Dayanidhi Maran. Prakash Karata, joining in the chorus, also demanded the resignation of the Union Textile Minister.
I came to meet Madam Jayalalitha after assumption of the office of Chief Minister. This is my first visit to Chennai. Well, what I've seen of the issues which have been raised in connection with Mr. Dayanidhi Maran as Minister of Telecom regarding the allocation of licenses and spectrum, I think it requires a serious investigation.
Well, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister, meanwhile, Jayalalitha, today launched her government's populist initiative of providing 20 kgs of rice free of cost to all ration card holders in the state. Now, the AIADMK Supremo launched the scheme, keeping the promise made in her party's election manifesto. Now, the new scheme will benefit more than 2 crore ration card holders in the state. The Chief Minister also insisted that these populist measures are designed for the welfare of the larger community. But moving ahead now, 2 weeks' time was what the Chief Minister, Ms. J.J. Lalitha, asked for when asked about a solution to the power crisis in the state last week. Now, in a fresh reaction to the electricity trouble that's been raging in the state, Amma said that corruption in the department will not be tolerated.
Some of the main reasons for the fall in production, power generation, was because of large-scale corruption in the TNEB, import of substandard coal. That was one of the main reasons for the drastic drop in power generation. And then, lack of proper maintenance. Now, there are different thermal units. At any given time, one or the other of the thermal units will have to be closed down for maintenance. So we should plan it properly so that the shutdown is staggered. We should not have a situation where more than one thermal unit is shut down. But here there was no planning in the DMK government, no proper organization. So for many days there was no power generation in the major thermal units. That also led to a fall in power generation. Now we will rectify the situation totally. We will root out corruption totally from the TNEB. We will see to it that generation is not only stepped up, not only reaches its full capacity, but it is also increased.
And in more issues coming to light, a day after the Central Administrative Tribunal or CAT quashed the reappointment of Letika Saran as the DGP, the state government has promised to look into the matter. Now, at a press briefing by the Chief Minister earlier today, Ms. Jayalalitha said that the case will be studied. In an appeal petition filed by R. Natraj, the CAT ordered that the reappointment of Ms. Saran, in fact, was legally invalid, following which the tribunal asked to consider him on a seniority basis. As R. Natraj has completed his term in the office, the CAT's plans may not spell these days as his last few in the department.
We have yet to study it in detail. We will study it and then give our opinion.
Now, moving ahead, do cell phones make you more prone to cancer? We get you some shocking details from a WHO report on the other side.